mighty name you have made. The supernatural. All I will just do, because I want us to close and leave here with the test by 11 on the dot. I know you don't believe, but the Lord will help you. The supernatural. Our heritage in Christ is the supernatural. Listen to that. I'll just teach for 15 minutes. Our heritage, my heritage in God, is the supernatural. There's a woman here, the Lord said, it's time for you to be on your own. You have been serving others for too long. It's time for you, even as the nation of Nigeria celebrates our independence on this October 4th, I declare your whole independence has come. Come, let me agree with you. Where are you? Come. Woman, you want to be your own boss. Not because somebody taught you a seminar, but you've been serving others, even those that are your mates, that are younger than you. But I release a mantle of leadership, a mantle of rulership upon your life now. Enough is enough. You will no longer serve. It's time for you to be served. Take now, Eba. Take now, Eba. Baron Shigapai. Parapastor Fabiata. Eba. Parapastor Fabiata. Mantle of leadership. Mantle of Eba. Mantle of leadership. Super Papa Yaka Pastor Vidas. Every spirit of servitude, every spirit of servitude is broken over your life and family. Be on your own. Be your own master. Be your own boss. The wisdom, the will without, the capital is released to your hands now. That dream of always losing articles, items belonging to you, I decree now, even that you just need to prevent it, that category. In the name of Jesus, that dream of always losing things, I won't call it out again, but I prophesy, Mother Post Tobias. It called Paya Pass Tobias. Come. Venina, come. Marosia Pa. Eleko Paya Pa. The robber. The thief and the robber are signed to be taken from you. When you are sick, lift up your two hands. I prophesy that in the name of Jesus, lift up your two hands. That the agenda of the robber is over now. Let that thing be arrested now. Let that enemy be arrested now. And what he has stolen from you is restored. Proverbs 6 verse 31, when a thief is caught, he's made to pay back in sevenfold. Whatever has been stolen from you is paid back time. Now in the name of Jesus. Freedom. Now. By the power of God. Freedom. I shut up and I come here. Contributing to this. God bless that sister that led us. Please celebrate her. Thank you. She's doing well. Thank you so much. That was awesome. Behold, I pray, whom the Lord hath given me are for signs and wonders in Israel. From the Lord of hosts, who dwelleth in Zion. But the one thing you must know is that the supernatural is your heritage as a believer. You are not meant to run after them. They are meant to run after you. The supernatural is your identity. Anywhere you appear, the supernatural must appear. The natural ceases and the supernatural takes over. Why? Because you come from the Lord of hosts who dwells in Zion. Behold, I and the children whom the Lord hath given me, we are for signs and wonders in Israel from the Lord of hosts who dwells in Zion. When a believer disregards the supernatural, he or she comes short of his or her full destiny in Christ. Our full destiny in Christ is that of the supernatural. Listen to me, my challenge to us this morning is that all of us, we are tired of seeing the natural. It's time to see the supernatural. The supernatural is that part that provokes signs and wonders. It's that part that makes men to wonder. People have predicted your life too much. People have predicted your business too much. They can even calculate your turnover, your profit margin in a month because they have been around you for so long. They have naturalized your life. However, the Bible says in John chapter 3, verse number 6, he that is born of the Spirit is spirit. You are not of the flesh, you are of God. Therefore, nothing about you again should be natural in the name of Jesus Christ. The true worth of a believer is delivered in the realm of the supernatural. The supernatural is what validates our Christian faith. You are not a believer, you are not a Christian if the supernatural is lacking in your life. So, in this 2-day conference, it is my desire under God to help us achieve a few things, even as we continue in the month of October. The month of October has been declared in advance as our month of supernatural lifestyle. You are going to see supernatural results. You see, in the supernatural, there are many segments. It's not all about miracle signs and wonders, but your life becomes a sign to your world. For instance, there's something called supernatural supplies. What is supernatural supplies? A kind of miraculous provision that happens that before the need arises, the provision is waiting. Ever before Elijah will be in need, the raven has been prepared. Even when the brook will dry up, a widow in Zarephath has been prepared. We serve a God of supernatural supplies. There's something called supernatural health, supernatural healing. For those that are sick, you shall be healed supernaturally. There is also supernatural health, that you don't have to be sick again. You just remain supernaturally. Not because you are eating right alone, not because you are resting alone. Those things are good, but there is a hand of God that sustains you. But all of these things answer to knowledge, as I'll be teaching shortly. So today, what I just want to do with you is just to help us realize our supernatural identity. In that John 3 that I called for, John 3, 6 and 8. John chapter 3, Jesus speaking, verses 6 and 8. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Verse 8 now. The wind bloweth where it listeth, where it wants to go. And thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it cometh, and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. May your response and your lifestyle be like the wind from now. They can't trap it. They can't say this is where it's coming from. They can't say this is where it's going. They only see its manifestation and they are in awe. They are in wonder again. May that be your dimension from now. Like I said, we are tired of seeing your supernatural dimension. It's time for the world to see the supernatural dimensions. Two things you need to know. Number one, your identity in the supernatural. Number one, you are a supernatural being. Only supernatural being can manifest supernatural results. Until you are a supernatural being, you cannot manifest supernatural results. How do I come about that? In the place that we just read,
John 3 verse 6. He that is born of the flesh is of the flesh. He that is born of the spirit is of the spirit. All I want to do in this conference is to, by the help of God, open our understanding to what we already are. Nobody is going to make you supernatural. You are already it. But you need to be aware. You need to know. Come into the understanding that I am supernatural. Can you say to your neighbor, I am supernatural? When you became born again, you became supernatural. Remember, man was first made in the image and the likeness of God. Until sin came, sin made us natural again. But Christ came and took our place in death and came back to us, restoring to us that which we lost with God. And that's our supernatural entity, our supernatural identity. So you are a supernatural being. You are not a natural being. Stop saying be the masses. Stop saying the poor masses. Stop considering yourself as one of them. There is something about you that stands you out. Ah, a supernatural. And because you are a supernatural being, you have the right to manifest in the supernatural. Number two, you are a God. G-O-D. You are a God. Psalm 82, please. Verses 5 to 7. Very quickly. You are a God. Can you help me say to your neighbor, I am a God? Your neighbor is feeling spiritual. Can I say I'm a God? Yeah, no. It's only God that is God. Help me tell him again. Pastor said you are a God. It's not only pastor that said it. The Bible says you are God. Can we see that? They know not. Listen to this carefully. Neither will they understand. So it's a function of understanding who they are. Knowing who they have always been. They walk on in darkness as a result of this lack of understanding. All the foundations of the heart are out of course. Everything is disorderly. I have said, what? Ye are gods, and all of you are the children of the Most High God. Who are the gods? The children of the Most High God. Who are the children of the Most High God? Your hands up. If you are a child of God, then you are a God. Can you say that to me? I am a God. Because I'm a child of God. Before somebody will say, Pastor, that only exists in the Old Testament. Give me the New Testament equivalent. John chapter 10, verse 34 to 35. Just a little teaching, and we go this way. Last minute miracles coming to your house now. They just reversed that truck and it's entering into your house. It will have missed your house, but for mercy. May you testify of that mercy. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law? I said. So it was not just any psalmist that was just quoting that. No, Jesus had to tell them, remember in your law, in the book of Psalms, I said it through David, your father, that you are gods. So when they are mentioning the gods on the earth, you qualify as one of them. It's not only Shango and Ogun and all those of Atala that are the gods. You are even in a superior class to them. They are Matior. Hello? You are in a superior, I didn't write the Bible. Jesus did. And he said, you are in a superior class. I'll be showing you shortly. Because once you understand this, the supernatural becomes vague to you. You will think it's just the exclusive bizarre of certain pastors, certain prophets and apostles. But no, we are all gods as long as we are the children of the Most High God. Next verse, 35. I love this 35. If he called them gods, why did he call them gods? What is the criterion? Unto whom the word of God came. What is the criterion? The word of God came to them and they became gods. Have you not read in your Bible, John 6 verse 63, the words I speak unto you, they are what? Spirit, not letters. Spirit and their life, when they enter into you, Ezekiel 2 verse 2,
And he spake unto me, and the Spirit entered into me and set me on my feet. I prophesy, may your eyes be opened. You can be a lion, but until you know a lion, be like a sheep. You can be an eagle, but you will think you are a chicken. You be misbehaving like a chicken, looking for worms to scratch the ground, just to scratch for insects. But the day you realize your equal identity, you soar. I prophesy you will fly again. You are going to soar again. Somebody has been soaring before, but your mentality brought you to the level of chicken. I prophesy a change of mind for you now. A miracle of an open of eyes. A miracle of the open of eyes. Of the opening of eyes. If he called them God unto whom the word of God came, and the scripture cannot be broken. You are God's. So when you wake up in the morning and you are feeling somehow, remind yourself, I'm a God, I'm a deity. You see, these are things that people say, think they are proud. When Bishop Oyedepo started saying all these things in the 1980s, people said, message is this man preaching? You are teaching believers to be proud, as they don't show today. Look at the results. For wisdom is justified of achievement. It takes God to have God kind of result. I prophesy to you, may your eyes be open now. So that the next time, when they say we want to do a deal of 15 million, you won't begin to fast and pray for how much 15 million. The Lord will so increase your capacity that you are releasing 20 million naira for business, legit business, and you won't feel it. You know why people are frowning? You know why people are angry? And angry at their wives and their children today? It's because of money. It's because of finance. No finance, no romance. Feelings notwithstanding. Every man will tell you that. But I place in your hands today capacity beyond your age. Somebody say, what is the meaning of that prayer? Go and check out the list of young billionaires that are affecting the world today. They are less than 35. Capacity beyond the age of their fathers. I decree and I declare, a man that can believe this, a woman under the sound of my voice that can believe this, if you can't believe it for yourself, believe it for your children. I prophesy, capacity beyond your age is put hence now. How do I walk the supernatural? For the sake of time, you must believe in the supernatural. Mark 16, 17 to 18. And these signs shall follow. Others are trying to look for them, but because you believe, they follow. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall drink anything deadly shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands upon the sick and they shall recover. Five supernatural signs. Why? They believe. Taking up serpent. They believe. Believe you are a creator of the supernatural first of all before you can manifest it. Who you are determines what you do. Who you are determines what you can hear. Who you are determines what you can achieve. It starts with being. You are a supernatural being. Believe it. And number two, possess a far above mentality. Bishop Oyedepo will always call it a far above all mentality. If there's anything complex, the superiority complex, not inferiority complex. Never see yourself as lower than anybody on the face of the earth. Hello? The only privilege that anybody has will be what they know more than you, the grace upon your lives, and the association around your lives. Nothing more. That's the only difference. The only difference between the greatest man of God and this little boy standing is just in three things. The knowledge in their head. The thing, there are things I still struggle with, but Dr. Paul eventually will come here and with the striking of his fingers, he gets it done. Why? It's not because he's taller or because God loves him more than he loves me. No, he has loved us all with everlasting love. But there's a difference. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. true knowledge
shall be just be delivered. Why would Pastor Adeboye just say casually, you are blessed, and millions of people and hundreds of millions on televisions across the world are receiving it? Why? Mentality. Possess a far above mentality. Ephesians 2 verse 6. Let me help us this one. You are seated above to function in the supernatural. If you are seated below, you can function in the natural. But you are seated far above as a fashion designer. You are seated far above as a mechanic. You are seated far above as an exporter, as a real estate person. You are seated far above. You must be conscious of your location. Your location determines what you do. Ephesians 2 verse 6. Oh, not honor thy father. You're not talking parenting. 2 verse 6. And hath raised us up together. Who is doing this? Jesus. In his finished work at Calvary, this is what he did. He raised me. When he died on the cross, I died with him. When he was buried, I was buried with him. When he rose from the dead, I rose with him. And as I rose, he raised me. He lifted me up to be seated together with him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Far more. Give me Ephesians 1:21. Let's see the things that are below these heavenly places in Christ Jesus. So that you may not think it's just the moon and the stars and the names of Orion and Arion and Pleiades. No, 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 no. They are more than stars. 1 Ephesians 1:21. Far above. Give me 20 first, so that we can put this in context. Which he wrought. Why am I taking my time to teach this? The pastor may not be there tomorrow or tonight in your dream. When you have this mentality already settled in you, you become a God naturally. Because the word of God has come to you and you are able to dare the devil on your own. On your own. Why? Because there is something you know that gives confidence. Our confidence is not in both faith. If it is both faith, they will have taken me out since. We didn't start this thing today. Amen. Which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead. And look at where he put Jesus. And set him at his own right in heavenly places. Now go on, 21. Far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named. One of these names is COVID-19.
Hello.
When people say you cannot have COVID-19, check their confidence. Maybe they have gotten vaccine. If it is vaccine, forget it. If it's because you have gotten vaccine, you cannot have COVID-19, then you are not in this. You can have vaccine. We have nothing against vaccine. Yet, you will still say, I cannot have it. If any COVID-21 comes up in the future, I still cannot have it. Why? It's a disease of the Egyptian. Number one, it cannot come upon my Jewish man. I'm a Jew. I'm a spiritual Israelite. I cannot partake of the sickness and infirmity of the Egyptian. Number two, I have been raised above every name that is named. Not only in this world, COVID-19 is of this world. We know those that did it. We won't mention names now. We know the nations of the world. We know those set of people that brought about COVID-19. In this world, but not only of this world, but also in the world which is to come. If the devil becomes more powerful in the endless future and he invents certain things in the world to come, we have been raised far. Can somebody say thank you, Jesus? Jesus did it once and for all. This is the truth of the Bible. Go on, sir. 22. And has put all things. How many things? A few things. Some things, all things, under his feet, and gave him to be the head over all things to the church. A good example, if my head is inside the aeroplane, where we might be in Nigeria, my leg will be on the runway or the tarmac. Answer me now. Okay, let's assume my head is inside the first class cabin, my body will be in the economy class. No. Where is the head? Far above principalities and power, might and dominion, and every name that is named, not only this.
this world, but that which is to come. That is my head, Jesus Christ the head. And he has put all things under the head of the church, Jesus Christ himself. So guess where we the body is? The same place where the head is. So when Ephesians 2 verses, go back to that scripture now, 2 verses, when he now says, wherefore God has raised us up together, together. So when he raised Christ here, you were there. Hello? Just as Christ cannot be in the first class cabin of that plane going to Toronto, Canada, and you are in the economy of one black bus going to Oshodi, is it possible? Where Christ is, there am I. I'm letting you understand this thing, because most of the time it's so simple that we think, oh, entertain me, you know, these new creation realities. Ah, TP, that is the truth. It is the truth. And has raised us up together and made us to sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. You are in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Where are you? Somebody say, Pastor, I'm in Shasha. You are the one in Shasha. Me, I'm in where? Heavenly places in. I want you to be so convinced. Where am I? Where are you? I'm in heavenly places. What happens in that place? What are you above? I'm far above powers, principalities, might, dominion, every name. Poverty has a name, right? So is, are you above that name? HIV has a name. Jaundice has a name. MSS, sickle cell anemia has a name. Where are you? Far above. Ah! I want this, if this can sink, it will help you. Failure, the end of breakthrough is a name. Chronic singleness is a condition. Barrenness is the name of a condition. But where are you? Far above. See, these are the understanding that sponsors some of the crazy things we do. Some years ago, I was in my former church, and a lady came. We just finished prayer fire. It was on a Wednesday or Thursday night. And I was driving to the car to join my family to take them home. And they said, Pastor, she is a pastor's wife now, as we speak, in that church. He said, Pastor, there's something I've been going through for days now. On our window, we just see this giant flag, like the one in Southaway. I said, what? That's strange. I said, use fleets now. Okay, you know, I mean, why are you telling Pastor about this? He said, sir, we have used insects, we have done everything, we have killed, they keep coming back. I said, is there any dead rat? He said, no. We've checked everywhere. I said, okay, in the name of Jesus, this handkerchief is coming. It was, I always carry this. I want my friend, I said, if what is upon this head is oil and not water, then take it, go and hang it on the window, hang it on the burglary or whatever you call it. And let me see if they can hear that anointing. The following day was Friday. Alpha, I said, they didn't come. Do you want them to come back? Hello? And that was the end. That's what I'm saying. When the Bible says God so much wrought special miracles by the hands, give me that scripture, Act 19 or so, Act 19 verse 10. Special miracles were wrought by the hands of Paul, that even handkerchiefs, that's right. Verse 11 to 12. So that from his body, give it to me 11. God so wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul. But you understand, you think Paul was laying hands on every one of them. How many can you lay hands on? Look at verse 12. So that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirit went out from them. One of the testimonies I can never forget was the testimony of one of our sisters here. The baby is here now. She was pregnant. And she was brought by one. You see, when we say bring people to church, you will think it's because pastors want to feel high. No. Somebody's testimony is hanging in your invitation. So she brought this sister to church and she came. She was towards the end. I just lifted and the Lord showed me the baby. I just saw the womb. The baby was breathing. He said, come. What is this man saying? He said, baby is sitting. I said, yes, come. Lay hands right in front of everybody. We saw the baby move. And she feel confirmed. I said, go back. Bless the handkerchief. Give it to her. Go on another scan. Long story made short, scans that same day or same week was altered. The baby went back to normal as we have prayed for her. On the day of her delivery, she held the handkerchief.
Gnosis were saying, drop this handkerchief. Say, no, my pastor blessed it too. And said, I must hold it. She held on to that faith. And when the baby will come out, it was natural. Amen. Why? God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul. If he did it by the hands of Paul, he can do it by the hands of. Put your name. Olayinka. And that is why tomorrow, just like I announced to them on Sunday, we shall be releasing mantles. He told me this since last week. We shall be releasing. I will be giving it out one by one to everybody. Tomorrow again. Tomorrow is Independence. We invite everybody to come. Don't miss tomorrow. We'll be giving it out to everyone that will be here tomorrow. Tomorrow, by God's grace. What sponsors this understanding? You can do it by yourself. It's these things that we know. What you know qualifies you to operate in the supernatural. You must know, first of all, your identity. This is who I am. I'm not begging to be a sign. I'm not praying to God, Lord, do give me a miracle. God, man, do a miracle. No, I'm not praying that prayer. I'm already a sign and a wonder. Behold, I and the children whom the Lord has given me, we are for signs and wonders. There is somebody on this road. In a short while from now, people will be coming to you to ask, how did you do it? Now listen, the person I'm talking about now, you don't look like it now. But in a short while from now, men and women will come, how have you been doing it? And the same goes for everyone here. People will come to you and ask, how did you do it? Come, teach us the way. In this road too, they will come, teach us. In this side too, they will come, teach us the way. They will come to us in ministry. How have you been able to run this ministry debt free for years? And God opening doors for you. In the name of Jesus. Rest to your face. There's no time today. Already promised. Hebrews 4 verse 2. Please give me that scripture. And I want you to note this as you go. If you forget anything, don't forget this. Hebrews 4 verse 2. Why would somebody hear something like this and it doesn't profit them? One reason. For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith. Do you have faith now? The Bible says, Romans 10 verse 17, so then, faith cometh by what? Hearing. And hearing by the word of God. So now that you have received the word, I want you to confess now, Lord, I believe I'm a supernatural being. There is something supernatural about my life. I'm a supernatural being. I am not natural. My result cannot be natural anymore. Hold up, pastor, the house. Shaka paramino sa zepele pia pa ina koma oloko pondo mina pa pa ina pura ta shaka pondo ida ramani pa pura basta shaka pondo ina pa pa ina koma shila pa pa ina pa pa ina koma shila pa 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 ina koma
Oh, wow.
Tomorrow there will be impartation of the gift of the Spirit.
Come ready. Tomorrow I'm going to zero in on the gift of the Spirit called the working of miracles. I'm going to explain some things to you about that gift. So that you know everybody can do that because we are for signs. I am the children whom the Lord has given me. I'm releasing you from this mountain today as a miracle worker. In your field, in that field of real estate, you become a miracle worker. In that field of fashion design, in that field of exports, in that field of designing, in that field of whatever you do, you are becoming a miracle worker. For I am the children whom the Lord has given unto me. We are for signs, for wonders. Come about this you are supposed to die this year. Every out of your belly this year. I decree and I declare, let it pass them by.
Number three, the blessing that has your name written and signed on it, that the enemy has been saying over my dead body.
The enemy has said, I will pursue and overtake. But who is it that sees a thing that comes to pass when the Lord commanded it? Lord, I decree and declare, every enemy of your soul that is saying over their dead body, we watch his your hands. I prophesy, let them die.
Number three, that blessing that will delight your family, that will make your family to know a season of joy again. Weeping has endured for the night. Joy comes in the morning. I prophesy, please, don't laugh. The God of the supernatural, the God of the supernatural, the God of the supernatural visits your family with a tangible dimension of blessing. Number five, there are individuals that need to hold you, that you need to receive their calls. Because you have not received their call, you have been at this level. I prophesy, Esther 6 verse 1, on that night, King Ahasuerus could not sleep until the book of remembrance was brought. So I decree now, let that politician, let that person in government corridors, in the court of power, pick up his phone, pick up a phone, and let them call you.
Six, from the depth of my heart, from the depth of my belly, do I render this blessing to you? That in the name of Jesus, in blessing in this ember month, you shall be blessed. In lifting, you shall be lifted. In honor, you shall be honored. In preference, favor is what breaks protocol. They said you are not qualified. What do they mean? Not when you know God, not when you are a supernatural being, not when you carry supernatural favor. I prophesy, let the hand of supernatural favor come upon you now. Let it come upon you now. Let it come upon you now. Come upon you now. Take it now. Take it now. Favor. 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 Give it to favor. So that when they shall go, you are stepping out of September tonight, but not empty handed. No more, not empty handed. I prophet in the name of Jesus, carry the favor, the favor of God upon the Israelites, carry the favor. Let it come upon you now.
Even the stingiest amongst men and women, that is what it means to be a raven. Raven is a bird that eats his own children. But yet, God trusted the fish, the meat of Elijah, with such a man, with such a bird. And it only found way for any moment here. Yet, he was trusted with the blessing of the man of God. I prophesy, the ravens amongst men, in their own record, they have never done anybody good. But you shall be the one to pray.
In October, I will celebrate with your family. You have been clapping with others. This October, I will celebrate with your house. I will celebrate with your family. October is your month. October is your month of celebration. In the name of Jesus, in the name of God the Father. overtake you and become your new normal. To become your new identity. In the name of Jesus Christ. Anyone that calls you blessed is blessed. Anyone that rises up to curse you in the night or in the day, they go down for you to rise.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Take your seat. Let's go for Jesus.